This was a week that started off on the upside with a bit of arrogance after last week's plunge caused by the CPI report. But it went bad, quickly, as stocks tumbled a jarring 5% this week. Together with last week's 4.7% drop means that in just 2 weeks, the S&P 500 has lost nearly 10% of its value. The catalyst has now become clear, crystal clear. Powell has finally made it official that he will keep hiking rates well into the recession and beyond. And that does not bode well for investors, according to Ray Dalio, founder of the world's largest hedge fund, Bridgewater Associates. According to Dalio, you fight inflation with economic pain. Dalio explains that when the Fed raises interest rates to tame inflation, the discount rate goes up. When one makes an investment, one puts a lump sum payment for future cash flows, and then in order to say what they're worth, we take the present value of those, which you will use a discount rate. And that's what makes all boats rise and decline together. And so, inflation may be at a 40-year high, but on the bright side, we at least have housing imploding, the market crashing, the world in a global recession, and we can look forward to millions of unemployed workers. In the meantime, let's take a look at the charts. So let's start here with the 2-year weekly chart on the volatility index, or the fear gauge, and the symbol in the upper left, as you can see, is $VIX using stockcharts.com. Now, we've looked at this before, and this is a nice dish. From the upside here in the far left, we came on down, bottomed and based, and then came on up. So we're waiting for this move on the way up. We're only at 29.92, and I would imagine I'd like to get up to, say, this 35 measure. Now, if the market really is going to crash, we'll go through that 35 measure and continue on the upside. So we'll have to keep a watch on this. Down in the lower portion of the screen, you can see the MACD with the fast line here moving on up just barely above the zero line. So we'll have to watch that very carefully next week to see if it starts to bubble up and pop. Up here in the upper portion, we're looking at the RSI, and the RSI has crossed up and through the midline or 50 line. We're at 58.29. We need to watch that too, because it could move on up here toward that, say, 70 level, as it has done, say, back here. And if it gets up to that 70 level, that's going to bring us up here to this 35 range, and then we may break through, or we could reflect back down and bottom, base, and try it again. So keep your eyes open. Let's now go to our charts. And now we're looking at the 20-year monthly chart on the Fidelity NASDAQ Composite Index ETF. The symbol is ONEQ. And this is, again, the 20-year monthly. That top here rolled over. We came on down and just barely went through that 50 EMA, bottomed and based. We went on up in a rebound, but we got reflected back down at that point here, and we're coming on down and doing a test at this point of the previous lows. Will it be a successful test? Will it go lower or stay above? I'm not sure, but I don't think it really matters. Let's go take a look at the oscillators. Here we are, the MACD. That's my favorite oscillator. We still have a pretty good separation between the fast line there and the slow line here. And you know what that means? Still lots of volatility, as you've been experiencing. So we have plenty of that left to go. Now, we are heading on down. Are we going to go below that zero? Most likely, at least with the fast line. The slow line may not, but we'll have to wait and see on that. But looking here at the histogram, you can see this is very, very negative. Now, you can see the consolidation in this area of these lines. Now, even though we went further down to do another test at that point there, it really isn't much below, say, some of these others here. So to me, we're getting some congestion at this point in here, which to me is an early sign of a bottoming and basing. Now, don't get your hopes up too much, because I think we do have lots of time to go. Here, the price rate of change is still plummeting down to that point there. Again, wide separation between the fast line and the slow line. So we have a lot of time that we need to heal. Here in the RSI, we do have that bottom here. It's trying to get down. It's not quite there. We'll have to wait and see if it does continue on down. But right now, it looks like we do have a bit of positive improvement there. Into the stochastics, this looks very similar to what it did back, say, in 2008-2009. At least there's a lot of similarities. We're just moving through and down under that level 20, which means we're just barely into that oversold territory. Now, I'd like to see us go a little bit lower before we reverse and head up there with the fast line. And when we start heading up with the fast line, that's going to be one of your early signals that perhaps the worst has been and is past. Into the Williams, you can see here we're coming back down again into that oversold territory. Let's see if this gets down to that negative 100. I don't think it's going to, but we'll see. Right now, we just have a little bit of improvement, at least at that measure. Again, let's just wait and see what comes down here. But I do like the fact that we're back into that oversold territory, because what happens is more and more sellers are bailing. A lot of investors are throwing in the towel. And that's what you want to see, because that's when the opportunities come. This is a perfect market, in my humble opinion, to average in. You don't necessarily have to start now, but I would think that some values are presenting themselves in the market. So keep your eyes open. There should be lots of good deals out there. And I think soon enough, within the next few months to a quarter or so, would be the time to start putting some money to work. But as always, practice patience and prudence. And for today, that's Chew Dog Charts. Thank you.